I am back at this place, and it's raining, of course, as always. And I just made my first old coin find here. It's nothing special. I don't know if you can see that, but it's a 1917 wheat penny. And it was quite deep. Alright, I got something good here. Check this out. This came in as a penny. 43.44. But it's not a penny. It's 5-6 inches deep. It's very crusty. It's about the size of a quarter. This is about as clean as I can get it right here. And I can see the bust of something on here. Could this be a large cent? I don't know. I almost went by this because I thought it would be a regular copper penny, but it was fairly deep and it was making a really nice sound. I dug it mostly on the sound. I'll clean this up when I get home, see if I can figure out what it is. Well, it's been a while. I'm not finding much here. It's my second wheat penny. You might not be able to see it. I think it's a 1935. And it was way down in there sideways. About 8 inches. Keep trying. Okay, results of today's hunt. Oh, there's the trash. A couple of these, thought these were coins, but they're just blank. Disc shape thingies. One bullet. Three memorial pennies. This is a 1953 nickel. 2, 4, 6, 7 wheat pennies. And this coin, I believe, is an English farthing. You can't see anything on it, but let me see if I can get a better view on this. I think the date is supposed to be... I'm not sure if it's supposed to be right at the bottom there, or... bottom of the front. This is in pretty rough shape, as you can see. But I believe this is a pretty early English farthing. Yeah, there's a clad quarter just for size comparison. It's bigger than a quarter. Wish I could see the date on it, but maybe I'll try to do some cleaning on this one. I don't know. I put some oil on it, rinsed it off, and it's, I don't know if there's any hope for this or not. Anyway, that was a pretty interesting find. That's it, a lot of wheat pennies. Hardly any clad, a bunch of junk. See you next time.